Well, hi, my name is John Tooker. I'm an extension entomologist with Penn State, and today I'm going to talk to you about pheromone trapping. Standing in front of a cornfield here, a lot of caterpillars that are pests of corn can be easily controlled with BT technology, that is transgenic corn that's insecticidal to those insect species, but many aren't, and black cutworm is a great example of that. Black cutworm is not easily controlled with BT corn. It's not easily controlled with seed treatments. So one way to get a handle on your local population of black cutworm and understand if it's posing a threat to your field is to use a pheromone trap, which is just what I have here. This pheromone trap would be set with the pheromone of the female moth, and that smell of the female moth would attract the male moth. We would capture the male moths in the trap just by opening it up and looking at it and counting the number of moths. And based on the number of moths we find, we can assess whether there's this field or adjacent fields or even regional fields are at threat from black cutworm damage. So when you're looking for black cutworm, it's good to know what the moths look like. Most of the moths you're going to catch in a black cutworm trap are black cutworms. They're very specifically responding to the pheromone that the females produce. I happen to have some black cutworm moths here with me today. Here's a typical entomologist box of insects. And here is the moth, and they're very distinctive in that they have these distinct black dagger-like markings on the wing. So if you find a moth in your trap, oftentimes they look faded, a little bit beat up because they sat in the trap. Maybe the trap's rattling around in the wind or there's a little water in there. But these little black daggers are very distinctive and allow you to identify this specifically as a black cutworm. So when you see these moths, all you have to do is count them, and then you could share that information with someone like myself who's coordinating a regional effort to trap for black cutworm, and we can share that with a larger audience and tell people across the state what portions of the state are at risk from black cutworm that year. So there are kind of two reasons you can use pheromone traps to look for moths. One is to try to assess the population locally to see what the risk is to a particular field or a particular area from a moth pest species. Another reason is just to generally understand a population. So if you want to trap for black cutworm or other moths that can be trapped with pheromone traps, you can buy a trap like this. I bought this from a company called Great Lakes IPM, but they're widely available through Gempler's or other locations. And it comes in pieces. It has the base here, has the kind of the cap here, and then there's a lid that keeps rain out of it. We put the pheromone in this little cage. The cage kind of has a top to it. You pop that off, throw the pheromone inside, put that back together, and clip it together like this, and you're ready to trap. All you have to do is hang this next to a field on a shepherd's hook or on a some type of fence post. Keep it about 3 feet off the ground. Keep it away from a hedgerow because we don't want it too close to a hedgerow. We don't want to hang it from trees, for example, because we want that smell of the pheromone to disperse and to be able to attract the moths. If it's next to a hedgerow, the smell of the pheromone can get kind of tied up in the smell of the trees, and we just want to avoid that. The pheromone looks like a little eraser. I have one in my pocket here. Here's the pheromone. It looks like a little rubber eraser. The smell of the female moth is impregnated in this little eraser looking thing. We call it a septum. And then we just pop that septum into the top of the trap. And you're ready to go. I should say you're almost ready to go, because then when a moth gets in here, it's not going to die. We want the moth to die in the trap so we can count it. Then you just add an insecticidal strip, usually hang that in the trap using a paper clip, and then you really are ready to go. This strip is impregnated with a volatile insecticide that'll kill the moths in the trap, and then when you're ready, you just come and check the trap and see how many moths are inside. I recommend that folks check their traps every 4 days or every week or so. It certainly doesn't have to be every day, but the more the better, so we can trap the number of moths. When we're looking for a black cutworm, when we find 8 moths over the course of 2 nights, that's what we call a significant flight of moths. And then we know that that field, or even the adjacent fields, and again the region, are at a higher risk for damage from black cutworm. Then what we can do is we can start accumulating degree days. Degree days are just heat units based on the average temperature for every day. When we reach 300 degree days, then I recommend growers to go out in their field and look for black cutworm damage. The best way to handle black cutworm, the most economical way to deal with black cutworm, is to do a rescue treatment of insecticide. So if you find a damaging population in your field, Then you apply an insecticide if necessary. And it's all based off the timing that we can establish with a pheromone trap like this. Well, in Pennsylvania, we have a new pest species that attacks corn called western bean cutworm. This is a pest that we first detected in Pennsylvania in 2009, and we're using pheromone traps to understand how widespread this moth species is. We've only found a single caterpillar so far, so we're pretty sure it's not an economic pest in Pennsylvania. We're trying to use the traps to understand where the moths are to figure out which parts of the state are more at risk. So western bean cutworm is not a typical cutworm in that it's not cutting off plants early in the spring. It's a pest species of corn ears, just about this size corn. And it'll get, the individual caterpillars will get down in the ear and feed upon the kernels on the developing ear. Of course, that can be very damaging if the populations are high enough. But thus far in Pennsylvania, all we find is the moths, and we're using pheromone traps like these to understand which part of the state the populations are developing in, and then we can tell growers if they're at risk from damage from western bean cutworm or not. We can tell those growers if they should be scouting in their fields to look for their caterpillars, based on the high or low number of moths that they find in their traps. So that's western bean cutworm, a new pest in Pennsylvania.